Tokoh kami ialah Sibyl Kadigasu. Beliau merupakan pejuang wanita yang telah menolong dan memberi rawatan kepada penduduk papan semasa Jepun menyerang tanah Melayu.
Sibyl's mother in that bed would sit over there, and then there would be a makeshift bed for Sibyl and the two daughters.
Mm-hmm.
And Mrs. Weaver would sleep on the bench over here, and when doctor comes in at night, he would sleep on the bench over there as well.
Mm-hmm.
Upstairs is where all the men would sleep, and also where the food and clothes are kept.
Mm-hmm.
And in the back room here, kitchen set up here, the stove. Mm-hmm. And this is the later kitchen, you can see. The black of the smoke in that time. The first room is actually the dining room and also a tuition room for Dawn. And the back room is that room where they kept more supplies, and also that's the illegal night clinic when the anti-Japanese people came in from the back door.
Okay.
When I came in, it was absolutely filthy and took away 3 truckloads, and everything you see is brought in. When they left here, Sibyl was arrested in the 43 August. The rest of the people, well, she, her husband, and her adopted son, William Pillay, were arrested. And the rest of the family and the people who were staying here, their friends, the Weavers, they left in 1944, March, I think. Okay, so when they left, they took everything. Yeah, so whatever that you see is that this was all open dirt when I found it,
mm-hmm.
and it was all broken, it was covered up, filled up. So I dug it up and I found that the box was still there. The grey concrete is the original box.
Oh.
All the green one is my work, my repair.
How does she secretly help the Malaysian people, anti-Japanese army, without the Japanese knowledge?
It's a tough question. I think it was an open secret after some time. But how did she start? How did she help? Well, she trained Ho Tan Fook as a paramedic to take medicine into the hills,
okay.
and also to do, well, to give treatments.
So she taught him?
She taught him
oh.
as a paramedic, yeah? And she, of course, provided medicine.
Mm.
And then, of course, she would give information when asked.
Okay.
Yeah.
What do you think that drove her to help the Malayan people, anti-Japanese army?
Well, she listened to the radio, and Chichil was saying, everyone is a friend. If anyone who is against the Japanese is a friend. So she decided that, yeah. And when she was approached to help, she just did it because it's a medical person, you know,
yeah.
you help people in sickness.
Mm.
And the thing that caused her, the big thing was she was Catholic and she had a vision of God and she had to make
serve.
The ultimate sacrifice. So that's how she allowed herself to do all those things that were endangering her own life and the life of the people around here. And the ones she loved.
Okay. So how did she was captured by the Japanese?
She was betrayed. She was betrayed by the people. One person here, it seems, yeah? But of course, we don't want to mention, we don't want to talk too much about that.
Yeah.
There were other stories that said they found some medicine in the hills and traced it to her and so on. And there was one slip of paper which has written on it, S-A-B. Samoa Adabai. It stands for Samoa Adabai. And this is this is the code password, the code word she uses when to communicate with the people in the hills. You know, when things are okay, Samoa Adabai, yeah, S-A-B. So this is how apparently the Japanese found this, and you know, maybe one of the people they captured, and then that's how they traced to it. But she has managed to avoid arrest, traced mainly because they were looking for the wrong people. They were looking for a Chinese midwife because Sybil spoke fluent Cantonese.
Oh.
And also other, she was brought up by a Chinese ama in Penang. Yeah, but she also booked, I would assume, some Hokkien as well, you know, for being from Penang. Her daughter said to me, oh, if you didn't see her when she spoke Cantonese, you wouldn't know that she's not Chinese. Yeah. So she managed to avoid arrest because they were looking for the wrong figure. And I think they couldn't believe that she was quite a small woman. And such a small woman to be so bold and courageous, you know. When they first came to arrest people here, they took away doctor and William Pillay. And then only 3 days later, they came for her here.
So do you think her sacrifice is now well known even till today?
I think there's a certain amount of people know about sacrifice. The people, especially the older folks, yeah? A lot of older folks know about it. I mean, I had a lot of old people visiting because her book, No Drum Mercy, was a school text in the 50s and 60s.
Oh.
Yeah? No Drum Mercy, you should know that.
Yeah.
And that was republished in 2005. And then there's another book called Faces of Courage, which was also published in 2005, and it included the entire book of No Drum Mercy. Because 50 years after the book published in 1954, the book would have been, the copyright would have lapsed.
Yeah.
So anyone can publish it. I can publish it now if I want to.
So can you tell us a bit history of this clinic that is now converted into a historical gallery like that?
I don't understand the question.
How did this clinic, like when you came, how did you change it, or who changed it to an historical gallery?
I did.
Okay. Was this sometimes you have to, it's under the, what do you call that?
Under a law, or is it
under historical.
No, the government doesn't recognize her history.
So sad.
Because she worked for the anti-Japanese, and the anti-Japanese were actually mostly communists. So anyone associated with communists would not be recognized by the government.
But what was the issue that came up? They wanted to include her in the history books? They wanted to include her in the history books.
Well, I checked. Apparently, she's still in Form 5 history and as one of the unsung heroes. Standard 5 history book. Standard 5 history, you know, what the children know.
Children,
it should have been much more important than that. But she's not the only one. There was also the Tiger of Malaya, what's his name, a singer.
Chopped, right?
Yeah, there's quite a few other people.
Quite
a few other people.
So what drove you to actually change this place to a memorial? Like surely either you are inspired.
Terima kasih diucapkan kepada Encik Lau Siak Hong dan Dr. Muhammad P. Sulman Isa.